Hello, hello. Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to take a look at two of the new Harbor Freight solar panels and whether or not you can connect them. If you haven't seen the video on it, click the link above. Appreciate the support, the comments. I read all of them. You guys are what makes this channel happen. So we got two of them connected, running into the little DIY battery box that I did, and I finally completed it. So I may do a video on it. I'm not sure. Drop a comment if you want to see a video on it. Don't mind the mess here. It serves my purpose. It is water resistant. Water resistant. 12.8 volts. You see we're bringing in 34 watts. Almost 3 amp hours into the batteries. 36 watt hours. We're still bringing in about 2.5 amps. We had 7 amps peak. 12.14 volts was the minimum, so we have charged up. 96 watts were peak. And it has been raining out all day for the past couple days, so there's no real sun, just breaks in the clouds. But yeah, you can connect these panels together. If you look on the back, you'll see it says do not connect in series. And I believe there's a reason behind that, and it's my theory. I'm not sure if it's the truth, but we'll try it out eventually. Is when you run these in series, you're going to be adding up the voltage. So if it's a 18 to 22 volt panel, when you bring it back to the charge controller, it's going to be upwards of 48 volts. PWM charge controller, most of them, especially the ones at Harbor Freight sell, are only good for 12 volt systems. So when you run them in parallel, like this is right now, if you see, these are running parallel. It's an old Harbor Freight splitter that comes off the 100 watt panel kit, the old one. And I'm just doing a quick test with it. And that puts it in parallel, brings it back. Now parallel, if you see, is going to double the amperage and the wattage, but the voltage is going to stay the same. So it's still putting in the charge controller, I think on this cuts off at like 14.2, 14.3. So this will bring in the 14 volts and then cut off. But it's the amperage that shoots up when you run them in parallel. So that's another thing you have to watch out for, because I think their controllers are only rated for maybe 7 for the small one, and I think 30 or 20 for the big one, but they're no good. I've been through a lot of them. You have to get a decent quality one. So you can definitely add two of the panels in together, and it's going to be limited by the PWM charge controller or any other type that you use. You just have to watch the amperage. And then if you want to run these in series, you have to watch the voltage. But these are running parallel. And parallel is going to bring the 12 volts back with high amperage. And the charge controller I got inside this box takes care of that. You see it shot up to 7 amps already. So it's holding it just fine. 12.8. So we'll test it out some more and see what happens. Alright, so I hope that clears up why Harbor Freight says you cannot hook these, or it's not advisable to hook these in series. I do believe it's just because their charge controllers can't handle it. It's not that the actual panels can't be hooked in series, but we'll test that at a later date. So I hope this helps everybody in deciding how to set their solar system up. We'll check real quick what this got. Watt-hours in. It's not too bad for a rainy day. 7 amps peak. And that's because, like I said, we are running in parallel. Alright, I hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.